Okay.
Just recording it, no? Yeah. So, so let me take you through those basic idea. I mean, some tips about SEO. We will continue and then we will take your query, whatever the query you have, and we will do this today itself. I mean, whatever the meta title description, it's easy to do. But let me explain you what exactly should be the strategy out of it, the meta title and description. Okay.
Okay.
So I'm just sharing the screen. So your website is live, right?
Yes.
Okay, great.
It is live, yes. Some changes need to be pushed. It will be pushed by the evening, by the late evening.
Okay. So there is one thing over there. So whenever we are trying to do anything on SEO, the same things, the same fundamentals should be remain in our mind. Okay. For example, we have discussed what is keyword, what is long tail keyword. Okay. And we discussed a bit about, you know, basic tools of Uber suggest, and we are also going to discuss later on Google keyword planner, SEMrush, etc. But before that, I want you to more focus on few more idea about this keyword. I'm taking you step by step actually. So like, for example, we have discussed what is keyword, how to find keyword, what is long keyword, but in our website or on our web pages, what should be the right place of keyword? That is also more important. Like meta title is there, description is there. We have discussed the keyword should be in meta title, keyword should be in description, keyword should be in first 100 words. These things we have already discussed. Okay. Yes. Today I want to discuss that when we talk about page title, means meta title, how we can make it more attractive for users so that they click over it.
Okay.
So for example, let me do one thing. If I find top blogging tips, for example, I'm searching top blogging tips on Google and I find this top tips for a successful blog. This is the first thing I found. The second is 16 top tips, then 17 blogging tips, then 100 plus blogging tips. Now, do you see something common in these searches? There is no advertisement, first of all. There is no Google Ads. These are all organic. Okay, the first thing. The second thing you should notice, top tips for successful blog. This is coming on a first page. Theguardian.com is a blog name, but this blog is coming on a first page. First rank. The second rank is coming for this 16 top tips from blogging experts for beginners. Third is coming from this 17 blogging tips. Fourth is coming 100 plus blogging tips. Now, if you see carefully by these people, these are the professional website. These are big company like buffer.com, etc. These are the SEO tool company, you know, etc. company, blogging guide, blog titan. So these are the big companies, big professional bloggers or great professional people. Now, if you see the common trend, everybody is using a number over here. 1617100+101.
Yeah.
And some of them are using something in bracket as well. In bracket 2022. I mean, the new year. That actually work. So this is something I want to explain to you. Like this number and then this in bracket. So okay. I didn't find it, in a very different way. I just simply searched top blogging tips. And I got these suggestions. So what I think that these people know how to attract the user. So optimize the number or attractive words, like use brackets, some images and all. So.
Yeah.
So they are using a number like 21 tips, 51 tips, 100 plus tips, 40 plus tips, you know, they are using. And they're also using some brackets and bracket. Why bracket? Because, you know, if you look again, just look again. If you see it carefully, if something in bracket, then it is struck our mind. It clicks to our mind.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yes.
So 17 blogging tips for beginners, bracket may that actually work likha hua. So this is actually clicking our mind. Similarly, wo alag se hi dikh raha hai hame.
Yes.
Well, in this way, these people have used apostrophe, expert tips, apostrophe in this way. So the point is, we should write certain words which are not keywords, but which can attract the people to click on our link.
Okay, right.
So that is again a new idea for us. Whenever doing meta title, we should use certain numbers over there.
Okay.
So now this idea has come to your mind. So whenever you are planning your meta title, use certain number. Now, how can you write those numbers? You can only write those numbers if you are actually using those numbers as well. For example, if you're actually using those numbers in your blog.
Okay.
Otherwise, how would you write? You can't. So to your blogger, you should mention that we are writing in points. So we should focus on certain numbers as well. Subheading in this way.
Yes.
For example, if I talk about this blog, which we have written important on-page SEO elements, and there are 17 points over there, 17 on-page SEO elements, right? So yeah. If I put over here, I have not used that number over here. Can you see the meta title?
Yes, yes.
The meta title is on-page on the top. I hope you can see the meta title over here.
Yes.
Okay, when you put the cursor over here, it shows the meta title of the blog. So the meta title is on-page SEO elements explained easy. Okay. So explained easy written just to attract the users. So I could write what changes I could make it over here. I could mention the 17 top on-page SEO elements. I mean, top 17 on-page SEO elements. Because when I write the word top, or when I use the word best, okay, when I use the word interesting, amazing, then it attracts more, basically an adjective to the number.
Yeah, right.
Okay, amazing SEO elements or something, or 17 on-page SEO elements. Now, another thing I could do over here, considering the strategy from the search which we saw, I could put in bracket as well, explained easy. I could mention explained easy or easy tips. I could write on-page SEO elements, and in bracket I could mention easy tips or actionable tips. So something I could write in bracket as well. So that could be more attractive. So this is an idea. If you have already written a blog, by learning these things, you can make changes in your meta title and description.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So this is one idea. And this is very useful and interesting. Now, optimize with a number or attractive words, bracket image, that's fine. Now coming to this, we cannot put an image. The image by mean is, when I'm writing, for example, this, and I have some infographics. So in this thing, I could say on-page SEO elements and bracket may, I could write infographic or see the graphics or something like this. In this way, I'm saying.
Okay.
Image doesn't mean that I'm going to put an image with a meta. That is not possible. By image, I mean to say in a bracket, I could say some image, some infographic, you know, some graphical representation, so that can also attract the user. Okay, there are some graphical representation as well in this way.
Okay.
Now, Slug or web page, you understand what is Slug, right? That is a URL basically in this. So basically, if I show you an image, now look at this image, for example, this. Now this is, what is this Power BI report sample? What is this?
The blog.
Sorry, sir.
Power report sample. This is one of your blogs. The reports is there. How many?
I'm asking what is in circle. This is meta title or what? That's what is this?
Okay. Meta title.
Okay. In the second image, what is this?
Which one?
This
is Slug.
This is Slug or URL, right? And this is some content where we have the heading as Power BI report sample, right? So this is the same page. I just took two screenshot and mentioning the three things just to make you understand what is meta title, how do you see meta, although you know, but I'm just repeating, this is meta title, this is Slug, and this is a line. So what exactly I did, I find very interesting thing that I was working on this Power BI, I was targeting Power BI, but Power BI is a very competitive keyword. I was not able to target it so easy. So what I did, I used the LSI keyword. LSI means the close or related searches keyword, right?
Okay, yeah.
Okay, we discussed last time the example of Apple, right? Electronics, yes. MacBook, you know?
Yes.
You remember LSI? Milte Julte word, related searches, something like this?
Yes.
If you remember, I gave you an example of a soft skills blog where we mentioned the team building skills or time management writing. These all are close related words to the main keyword, which is soft skills. So LSI, what I thought, I cannot target this Power BI. So what I could do, I could find out the this LSI, and I also find that this is less competitive. So I just targeted this keyword. Now to target this keyword, and this strategy will come in your website as well. So now when I search this Power BI report sample, although it is not very competitive, but definitely there is a competition. So I couldn't come on a first page so easy. Okay, I do not have a blog on it. I just have a single page. Okay, I just open a page for you as well.
Okay.
Okay, so this is just a page. There is no content over there. Only meta title there, slug is there, is basics content over there, headline is there. And then this report sample, because this is basically we do for people who wants to learn Power BI. So we show that some sort of report sample, which is a basic report just to showcase the people that this is some way, this is a way you can create a report sample. But as a SEO person, I also got an idea. If I target this, then also it is possible. So what I did, Power BI report sample. So I'm not coming over here. Now these related searches, these help me in getting the LSI word, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I can do the Power BI sample dashboard. I can do the Power BI sample data Excel. I can do the Power BI sample PBIX as well. Right now what I did, Power BI report sample. So these all are all LSI. These kind of words I should use in my blog or in my content so that the page gets more LSI and I get higher ranker. Now coming to the second page, I'm searching whether the Edu4Sure is there or not. So Edu4Sure not is on the second page as well. Okay, that's fine. Now I'm coming to the third page. Although I want to come on the first page and first rank definitely, but I'm just trying to understand. I don't have any content. I only have a single page, which is a meta title, slug, some sort of heading in a content. That's it. So this is not a good idea, but this is not a bad idea if I just want to target a particular LSI. So now coming to the third page. So although I'm considering nobody's coming on a third page, but I'm trying to make you understand that I'm coming on a third page at least.
Yeah. So
from this, I just want to showcase you to give you more confidence that I can actually come on a first page as well if I write a particular blog on this Power BI report sample where I should mention 2-3 sample pages. Here, what I did, I just put a page and I'm just click over here and I'm showcasing the people because my target audience is just looking a sample paper or sample report, what they will learn with this course, the Power BI, right?
Yeah.
So I just made this way. But from this understanding, I just want to give you a very practical understanding that I don't want to tell you that you will immediately come on a first page. But if you try these strategy, right now you're coming on a third page at least. And if you write a particular blog or something, 2-3 blogs in parts where you are talking about the Power BI report sample, Power BI dashboard, Power BI PBIX, these kind of keywords you are using, you can definitely come on a first page as well because this is less competitive and this could be a good strategy to focus upon.
Okay.
So did you understand this point?
Yes.
So whenever you are working on your keywords, you can find LSI keywords and then you can start writing either a blog on a particular LSI. And from that particular blog, you can interlink to your main page or your main blog. And in this way, you can give them a more rank, a better rank.
Okay.
Okay. So we can use these kind of strategy. So now coming to this, this is matter and you understand it. Okay. This is a slug. Now we are supposed to write short URL, very short URL.
Yeah.
Okay. This. So try to write short URL. Do not try to write long URL. For example, suppose you are targeting how to plan your career after 12.
Yeah.
So write in short, plan career after 12 or something after 12th career, something like this. I mean, make it very short.
Okay.
Your URL should be short. I think I discussed last time as well when we shared it on for example, on WhatsApp or somewhere. So dot, dot, dot is visible and it looks spammy.
Right.
So we should make it short. Now I'm trying to make it more short, means shorter than short. This is what I'm trying to focus upon. So if possible, try to keep short URLs. Okay.
Okay.
So you understood these all points. The right place of keyword is a page title, Slug, first 100 words. This we discuss in detail. We discussed the density already. Now this is a place, right place. So in the right place in title, you are supposed to use certain numbers, some attractive words like best, top, easy, interesting, amazing. And you should use brackets. Okay. In this kind of, in this way, you can actually attract the users. Okay.
Yeah.
And as discussed last time as well, the longer content. Why the longer content? Because if you are trying to focus on LSI keywords, you are using closely related keywords, then these long articles would help you.
Okay.
Just for example, we discussed earlier, but I'm just quickly taking you just a recap. For example, we are targeting here soft skills. Okay. You can see the meta title over here on the top. Soft skills, the most important skill ever. So soft skills is our target, but this is a high competition keyword. So we are having these long list of, you can say LSI, communication, clarity, confidence. So these all words are basically LSI for soft. These are all soft skills. Teamwork is a soft skills. Conflict management is a soft. So Google understand this because people search in a way.
Okay.
Like problem solving as a soft skill. People search in a way. Is creativity a soft skills? Is mind mapping? Is a work ethics? Is a interpersonal skill? So Google always understand what the people are searching because that is the job of a Google. And according to those understanding, Google also ranks you if you are using those LSI, closely related words.
Okay. Okay.
Like leadership, project management, time management, attention to detail, these all soft skills part. So your main keyword is soft skills. Now what you would do, you will also start writing blogs on these leadership, mentoring, project, and you will try to give links to this main key, main blog as well.
Okay. Okay.
You got my point?
So, yes.
So this is something called usage of LSI. For getting LSI, you should write a long blog. So this is a very long, lengthy blog. Forget about it. This is more than 8,000 we discussed last time. I think 9,000 something. But as per research, it shows the Google also focus on a content 1,800 to 2,000. Although we will work on a plan by your manager as well, which is I think lesser words, 400, 500 words. But this is something you should always keep in your mind that you are supposed to write long content as well to rank. And once you rank, nobody can hit you easily.
Okay.
So coming to the next idea, and then we will move to your this meta title. So this is Pogo Stick problem. So Pogo Stick, what is the Pogo Stick problem in this? So when I'm searching something, like for example, let me search how to bridge. I'm just taking an example from this. So I got this. Okay. I got this blog. So I click on this blog, which is coming on the first rank. Yeah. 5 ways to bridge the generation gap between employees. Okay. And I find that I was not looking for a generation gap between employees. I quickly came back and I went slower to next and I click on this second one.
Hmm.
7 ways to bridge the generation gap. So I was actually looking a blog like this, which was basically a generation gap between parents and children. Okay.
Yeah.
So what I want to tell you that what exactly happens if somebody is searching. Now somebody is searching how to bridge generation gap. Now he didn't mention whether he's looking a generation gap between employees or generation gap between parents and child. Right?
Yeah. Right.
So Google basically showed the searches, which was based on the keyword he was searching, how to bridge generation gap. So this was the first search between employees. The second was a common search, but when I click, I find that this was talking about the parents and children. Although you can read the meta description as well, a few tips for the children to bridge the generation gap between them and their parents. From here also, I can understand that this blog is about the gap between children and parents.
Yes.
Okay. So in this way, again, if I look at a third block, if a generation gap or an age experience related issue is getting in the way of it. So this is basically a generation gap between, again, your manager, your experienced person or your team. So I'm not going to click over here. So based on the meta description, I'm clicking it, clicking this link because I'm looking for a generation gap between children and parents. If I was, searching for this, then definitely I would click over here and it would stay there. But what actually I did, I click over here. Let us say it is this, and then I find the heading and I go back because I'm not going to know about the generation gap between employees. Now I'm clicking on this second, and definitely I find the generation gap. I see the image. The image clearly say it is about the parents and children, so giving me some idea. And then I can easily see here the some points, and based on the points I'm just searching. So I'm making my blog also with heading and subheading so that I can easily engage my users.
Yeah.
Users will easily engage with your site if you have a very clean way of, you know, presentation of your blog.
Okay.
Like what are the tips? Communicate, spend more time. So suppose I am just scheming it. I just read this, spend time, show genuine. I'm not reading this. I'm just skimming it. I mean, very quickly. Even I'm happy. Because from this, share your problems. I don't want to read this because I understand what I am trying to, what the blogger is trying to tell. Share your problems.
Yeah. Okay.
Act responsibly, have patience. I'm not going to read it. But from this, heading subheading, I'm getting a confidence in the blog that I'm getting what I was looking for.
Yeah.
Suppose I want to tell my kids that what are the tips, so I will just going through this header subheader, and I will understand what I should follow to teach my kids or something like this. Now, so I find this blog useful. Similarly, now there were two things you have noticed.
Yeah.
One thing that the user, I'm just closing it. So the user was looking for the bridge, the generation gap, but he didn't mention the employees. He didn't mention the parents, children, right? So the user was not wrong. You were also not wrong because you wrote a blog on employee part. Okay, that is also something. But still, by default, you got some harm because I clicked and I came back. So this is called this Pogo Stick problem, that you cannot, you know, escape yourself from this problem.
Okay.
Because let us say A is a percentage of people who click on your site, okay, who click on the search page, okay, and go to your website. From this example, you can understand, I searched how to bridge generation gap. I saw the website which was telling me how to bridge the gap between generation gap between employees. So this was a percentage who went over there.
Yeah.
Okay. But there were the B people who came back. Okay. They came to website, but they came back.
Okay.
Okay. And then the C is something which is on a second option. I mean the second website on a SERP.
Okay.
So search engine has shown me certain options. So I saw that I came back, I click on a second. In this way, Google understand the first click was not useful for this user. So if somebody is clicking and coming back, okay, and going to the second option, it means your average Pogo stick rate will be high. Means the Pogo, I mean, you know the Pogo, you can understand from this image, you're jumping, just jumping.
Yeah.
So if your average Pogo, so this is a game as well. Okay, this is an animated video. This is just an animation, a cartoon video. But if you Google, so this is a game as well.
Yeah, your video actually, your screen just went off right now.
Okay, let's just give me. I don't understand why the screen went off. So when the screen went off, I could not.
just now.
So you were here when I was writing this A, B, and C, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so what actually happens, you can see this image. This is basically some sort of game. There's a pogo stick, and if you are jumping, so your pogo stick rate is getting higher, because if you're jumping from 1 to 2, so Google notices it. It is not that easy to understand from a calculation point of view, but from a common understanding, the point is, if you're coming, let me explain you this way again, it will be better. So I was searching how to bridge generation gap. I went to this website. I saw this website is about between employees. So I didn't want to go through this website. I came back. Okay. And I went to the second link. I find, yes, this website was having a parents and children. I was looking for this. I see that there are points, some points. I spend time over there. And if suppose this blog was also very clumsy or not attractive, so definitely I will go back and I will go with the next option.
Yeah.
Right. So maybe I go with their parents and child, and I find that this is better. I find, yes, this is better. This is having all kind of heading, subheading. So again, the second blog, this blog, if it was not having heading, subheading or some sort of good content, again, it will lose the game. So the Pogo stick rate would be higher for the sites where the person is coming and going back. So we need to target the Pogo stick rate should be lower. So the great pages or great sites would have low rate, because the person who are searching their site, they're coming, they're spending time, and then they're going back, and they're not going to again another website. But you can ask me a question over here, how I can control it? Because I wrote a blog about the bridge generation gap between employees. How would I know? So you can't control it.
Yeah.
Okay. You can't control it. The only thing is in your control, that when somebody is coming to your website, you should write in a way the person should feel easy to navigate your site. For example, if I'm clicking on this one, so I'm directly going to this website and I'm just reading these points and that's it.
Okay.
So this is some sort of quickly jump across section. So suppose you have a very lengthy blog. You remember this blog. If you start scrolling it, you will not get anything. You will get mad about it. I mean, suppose you are reading it. So it is going so long and all. But if you have certain kind of, you know, snapshot or some sort of summarize, quick jump as well. So I want to read only about this interpersonal skills. So I just click over here. I go to interpersonal skills. That's it. So in this way, you will find this blog interesting, and you can subscribe to the newsletter, or you can just, you know, bookmark this page that I will come back again.
Okay.
So this is something in your control to make the UI, to make the navigation as simple as it, to make the content compelling, to make the content attractive to the users. This is in your control in a Pogo Stick problem. Otherwise, you cannot control. Now, like we are selling online courses, for example. We are selling a lot of courses. We are selling these courses. Okay, these are the courses. Now people are searching the certificate courses, but they are not finding the course which we have. We do not have a course, for example, we don't have a course on ethical hacking, for example.
Yeah.
So in this way, the people will go back. Or suppose we have the courses, but these all are paid courses and people are looking for free courses. Then again, it is a problem. So Pogo stick problem is very common. You cannot control in so many ways, because 90% of the people will search something which may not be relevant for them on your site. So they can, you know, bounce back, or they can jump from there. But other things like heading, subheading, engaging content, using images, using simple navigation, that is in your control. Okay. So now, again, I will discuss some sort of, you know, solutions to these kind of problems. So as I said, 90% people just search for no exact relation to your business. So how do you solve it? So first of all, you have to understand the user's mindset, what kind of things they're looking for, they're searching, which is in your content.
Yeah.
Suppose I'm searching how to earn money online. So these kind of questions answer should be in your blog. If I'm searching how to earn money online, so your blog is talking about the how to earn money online and giving me good recommendation, good suggestion, definitely I would be there. So then again, you will try to understand, okay, and how do you do these kind of survey? Ask your people, ask your customers, ask your employees, ask your brother, sister, whoever you think can give you the right answers to your survey. So you can give them the option. Okay, what? Tell me what is the most most important key phrase you would search when you are searching the watches online. Okay, when you are searching to buy the books online, and when you are searching some online courses, and when you are searching some coaching online. So what kind of keywords? So in this way, you understand their mindset. Accordingly, you plan your content as well. I mean, the context. Second thing is design and UX. User experience design, how easy it is to navigate, how easy it is taking your users, that is also very important. If your design and UX is not important, your content is good, then again, the user will go back.
Okay.
And the third is very important factor, that load speed and device support. Now, what is load speed? When you are searching this load speed, okay?
Yeah.
Let me take you. Okay, I was just searching these kind of strategy and I found this interesting thing. So this is the second point. When we are talking about a second point, this design and UX. So there is a website you can try in free time, dribble.com. Okay, you can do some sort of, you know, world top designer creatives. If you need their help and all something, you can try it.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
So there are a lot of other websites, but this is something referred by some professional for which I learned this Pogo Stick as well. Definitely, I learned it somewhere, this Pogo Stick thing. Okay, so he suggested this dribble.com. Now, coming to this load speed and device support, this is very important. And this you should tell your developer as well to do. What is load speed? So there are so many websites, you know, which tells you what should be your load speed and all. But I will suggest you to go with the Google page speed. Okay? And in this way, page speed insight. Okay. So suppose I mentioned the facebook.com, I want to see how fast it is. I want to analyze it. So it will give me. Enter a valid URL. It is asking me enter the valid URL. Facebook, I want to search. So now this is the Google page speed insight is analyzing this particular website, the particular domain, that how fast it is. Okay. So as we use Facebook, that is why I'm taking this example. Okay. So discover what you need. Really 87, which is a good score. Okay. 90 to 100 is showing very good, but it is still good. 87 is coming the score. Now you can see a lot of options over there. The time to detective is 2.9 second speed index. So there are a lot of things. You're not supposed to, you know, check each and everything, but whatever possible you should do.
Okay.
So what you will do, you will put your domain and you will check a mobile. The people, you can see the third point, load space plus device support. If the people are using Facebook on mobile, then definitely you should focus first on mobile.
Yeah,
the speed of on mobile, because you know what actually happens if it is taking more time, if it is more time taking time more to open or browsing, you will not use this. Okay, in this way. But 87 overall score is very good. Now the desktop scores is 100.
Okay.
Now desktop performance is very good.
Yeah,
you can see the time to interactive is only 0.4 second now.
Yeah.
So,
right.
So you can see the difference. With the mobile, it was higher, 2.9 second, and that is why it was 87. It was 20. So it is giving the red indication, means orange. It means there can be some improvement. It is green, it is fine. 2.9 second is fine. So it also tells you which is green, which is orange, which is red, and accordingly you should focus on. So here I'm not supposed to focus on these four. I am supposed to focus on this. First, contentful. So when I am doing this, it also explains me how to do this. For example, reduce unused JavaScript. There are unused JavaScript which can be reduced. So these are the files, or these are the links, whatever is URL, you can just do it.
Okay.
So whatever possible way, you can reduce this. Fine.
Okay.
So in this way, we can do this kind of problem solve. Now I will go to the next things later, because we have 20 minutes left to discuss your idea as well. Now tell me what exactly you are trying to achieve, and then we will do the meta title description for that.
Okay. For the Brain Mind Global website, I'll just give you the link also.
On the chat, you can give me. I'm just writing you hi on the chat in the here only, and my MS Teams only. Did you get my hello on this?
I'll check. No, chat is disabled. I don't know why.
Oh, is it? Okay, I will see later on. You just WhatsApp me, okay? You just WhatsApp me.
Okay.
Yeah, just WhatsApp me over here.
Okay. Yeah, I've given you.
Yes. So for this main page, basically for the home page, you are trying to target the meta title description, right?
Yes.
So I will make you understand how to do it so that you can do it for all the pages. Right now, on my site, it is showing this site can't be registered. I think it is still in process.
Oh, you've opened it on desktop or mobile?
No, laptop only.
Laptop only. Oh, I am able to see. I don't know why.
See, sometimes it happens. That's fine. That is not a problem. We can just discuss and I can tell you. But do you have an access to edit the meta title and description, the dashboard access, like I showed you in Edu4Sure?
That the developers will do.
Okay, no issue.
So
what I do, I totally understand. I will just give you the meta title and description from my side, and I will tell you how I'm doing it, so that, you know, later on you can do it yourself.
Okay. Should I share my screen and show you the website?
Yeah, definitely. If that would be easy for me as well, because we will discuss the keywords.
Okay. This is the home page. So she has two companies, Brain and Mind and EuropeHR.
Just hold on. Brain Mind Global.com. I'm just trying to understand why it is not working on my laptop. Huh?
Okay.
It is the same link which you shared me on WhatsApp. I clicked over here. It is not working. Anyway, okay. You can tell your developer as well that, or you can give some of your friends or anybody in your office the link, whether they are able to open it or not.
Okay.
No, it is looking nice. The site is looking nice now. Earlier you gave me the same site, but that was, I think, totally, you can say, in very initial phase, I think.
Yes. So we have put some words, they come one after another. Mm-hmm. Productivity, intelligence, consciousness. So this is a front page.
Mm-hmm.
So her life transformation expertise, we've written everything over here. So I think you will have to see the website and analyze the keywords, or you can tell us like that only.
No, I definitely have to go through the content first, okay, and then I will understand, but I can guide you how I'm going to do it, and I'm going to going it right away only. Okay. Because we have time. Yes. Okay. So just open it. Because the problem is I cannot open in my laptop. So you just have to take me through. Yeah, just open the site.
Yeah, yes. Can you see?
Yeah. So I want to understand, what is your business? I mean, you tell me, going to the just tell me.
So basically she is doing coaching, one-to-one coaching for now. She will be doing consulting also on corporate programs also, but abhi one-to-one coaching. So there are different formulas that she's using. One coaching is the stress resilience formula to reduce the stress that we all have in
just hold now. Just give me a minute. Yeah, just okay. Stress resilience formula. Okay, I'm just doing one thing which I did earlier as well. I'm opening the Uber suggest. Okay, I'm just going to understand how it, and you are targeting the US segment, right? US market.
Yes.
So can you just spell the word stress, stress, again?
Yeah, stress resilience, resilience, LINCE.
Results. So I want to understand, you are basically targeting the audience, you know, who are looking for these kind of training, stress resilience.
Yes, who are looking for mental peace, stress, anxiety related problems, who are looking for how they can do better productivity.
I got your point. We will go one by one. I understand your concept. And basically the stress management, how to become productive at workplace, these kind of things.
Okay. Yes.
How you can become more productive, or how you can be stress-free in workplace, or how you can be efficient. So these are all LSIs: efficient, more productive, stress-free in, at workplace in this.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm just giving you quick, you know, for this keyword, there's no difficulty level. So it is very easy to target. So for this particular keyword. So you will also do the same thing when we will sign up for the SEMrush and all, okay? Or you can do from UberSuggest as well. I am using UberSuggest. There's no difficult, I wrote it wrong. There's no search basically. Means the people are not searching it in US.
Okay.
Now if people are not searching it, and difficulty level is very easy, means only 12 score. And I told you 1 to 33 is easy. Paid we are not discussing, Google Ads we are not discussing, we are only discussing the organic way of searching. So difficulty level is easy and people are not searching. It means if you are using this word, you are writing a blog on this stress resilience formula, what is stress resilience formula, how to cope up with it, okay, what exactly you do with this formula. So this is a formula by your coach, right? This is what I'm understanding. Okay,
and
so
there has or more programs are there. I don't know why the developers haven't put it.
Okay, they will do it. That's fine. They may be doing it. That's fine. So what I understand, increase your information processing, improve your decision making, develop and sustain a laser. Now, when I talk about decision making, improve your decision making. Now I'm searching how to improve decision making, because people may search these things, right? How to improve decision making.
Yes.
Okay, suppose I'm running a business or I'm a manager, I may search how to. So I'm just trying to understand. Now, this is interesting. Now, when I search how to improve decision making, I'm sending you on WhatsApp as well. I find the volume 140 a month. I told you it is a month, right?
Yeah.
Volume is 140 and difficulty level is very high. It is 71, which is very high. So this is difficult to target. Okay, now I'm sending you. So these two. Now see, understand now, and which you have to put in your report as well when you're discussing with your manager. And we will discuss more. I'm just explaining these two first. So say this, nobody is searching. The first is stress resilience formula. Nobody is searching. There is no difficulty level. When I'm saying no difficulty level, means it is very easy. I mean, 12 is very easy and there is no search volume. So if you're putting this, you will not get any traffic because nobody is searching it, right?
Okay,
so we should not target it first. As per my understanding, we should not target this. In any case, in any case, when you will write a blog on it, Google will easily optimize it if you use the right set of keywords and all. But nobody is searching, so nobody is going to find your website as well using this keyword. Stress, because nobody is searching this keyword, right?
Yeah, right.
No, I'm not going to search what will happen in 2075. So whatever somebody writes on Google, nobody is going to come on the blog of that guy. Now, coming to the second important keyword, which I find from her program, that is the decision making, how to improve decision making. Now, 140 people are searching it, and these 140 people could be the leads as well. So, and difficulty level is also very high. And this difficulty level is high when I'm searching a long tail keyword, how to improve decision making. Suppose I make make it different, decision making made easy. Suppose I'm searching decision making made easy. I mean, nobody search this way. So that is why I'm trying to make you understand. When I search, so aapko ye batana hai report mein, theek hai unko?
Okay.
When I search decision made easy, the volume is coming, or my tool ka naam aapko already bata chuka hu, main mention bhi kar dunga yahan pe. Volume 10 aa raha hai and difficulty level aa raha hai 33.
Okay.
I'm using OpenSuggest, which is a keyword analysis tool, keyword research tool. Okay, and I'm searching for US market. I mean, how many people searching this as US?
Okay.
It could be different to different market, but yes, more or less, it is giving you right idea. So now these are the three things. If I'm searching this, how to improve decision making, the volume is 140, difficulty level is high. When I'm searching decision making made easy, the volume search is 10 a month. 10 people are searching, 10 searches are happening over there. And difficulty level is 33, which is easier than 71 difficulty level, right?
Yes.
Now it is up to you. How do you proceed with it? My suggestion? Nobody is going to search decision making made easy in a way that they want to learn decision making as well. Maybe yeah. They are just trying to read a blog, or they are just trying to find some book like English Grammar Made Easy, Word Power Made Easy. You know this book? So yeah. Maybe they are searching that way. So you have to understand the intention of the user, considering you are also a user.
Right.
Between these two searches, how to improve decision making and decision making made easy. Forget about the volume search. From this keyword only, how to improve decision making. What do you think? Who can be your target audience? I mean, lead.
How to improve decision making.
Definitely, because he's looking for an option, are looking for a solution that how he can improve his decision making.
Right.
So this is something you will target. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, second option is increase your information processing, improve long and short term memory formation, increase mental focus and productivity. Now, increase mental focus and productivity. This could be the second thing which can be important for your business, that how you can enhance your mental ability to work upon our things. So as I told you earlier as well, this is something, to be very honest, you know the SEO, you know the tricks, you know how to find it, because I can teach you, I can only guide you on how to reach the right set of keywords. But whoever is running a business, he or she is supposed to give you more ideas about it, right?
Okay.
And what could be the best key phrase search by your audience? For example, suppose I am running a business of online courses, which the people are learning, you know, online. So I will put the online certification courses as a meta title in my business. Would not I do? So let me give you an understanding. I'm just explaining you. I can do it whatever you want, but I just want you should also understand, because you will give me the ideas that these are the things she's primarily focusing on, and then it will take only 2 to 5 minutes to do the meta title and description.
Okay.
It is not, but before reaching that stage, we should first understand ourselves what we should put in meta title and description. See, we know the SEO, we know tools, we know how to do it. So it doesn't take a lot of time for us to do, but what takes time to understand the right audience intention when they are searching things. This only your owner can tell you. Now, now I'm sharing the screen to give you an insight, what I'm trying to explain you. So you can see my screen now, right?
Yes.
So for example, this is our business. Okay, Edu4Sure is our business. If I put a meta title, so it is saying corporate training, online certification courses, and then digital media service and training, right? Digital media service. Which comes SEO content, social media and all. Now, if you look at the first, in a meta title, if you look at the first phrase of meta title, it is showing me corporate training. So definitely we are primarily focusing on corporate training. Like I'm giving you one-to-one training, right? Similarly, second option is online certification courses. So this is what we do, the certification courses and all. Are you getting my point?
Yes.
So these are all courses we do. So the point is, because I know my business, I am doing that. Are you getting my point? So similarly, you are, let me try to open again your this Brain Mind Global, if now it gets open too, because it was not opening, you know, in my, I think it is still not opening. So when I look at your business, okay, can you share the screen now? Now I explain you. Just share the screen.
Here. Are you able to see it?
No, I'm not. You just share your screen. You have not shared it yet, I guess.
Achha, okay. Now is it visible?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. So see, you know your programs. So in your programs, you will mention you on a meta title. Can you put your cursor on meta title, please? On the right, top right side. Because you have not used a meta title. So for the time being, you can put this brainmindglobal.com. So aapka brand jo rahega, main WhatsApp kar raha hu aapko. For example, aap use edit kar lena spelling wagera jaise bhi aap likhte ho.
Haan.
Main apni taraf se ek example de raha hu, theek hai na? Is cheez ki bhi coaching hai, one to one coaching. For example, aapko is tarike se likhna hai jaise maine aapko WhatsApp kiya hai. Just ek example diya hai maine. One to one coaching. And whatever your business is, main thing is, okay? For example, improve. Humne kya discuss kiya? Decision making. One to one coaching, improve decision making. Fir wo vertical line and then your brand name, Brain Mind Global, jo bhi naam hai. Theek hai? Is tarike se aapko is page ko banana hai. To suppose aapne apne trainer se pucha, apne manager se pucha ki what are the most important thing people search. If they are searching decision making, so you will mention one to one decision making coaching.
Okay.
If they are searching how to improve work life balance, so one to one coaching work life balance. Simple. Main keywords.
Okay.
So in this way, this will be your meta title, and definitely brand name should be there at the end of every meta title.
Okay.
In this way. So this is first idea. So now it is easy for you to do the meta title.
Yes.
Okay. Whatever the main thing she tells you that I want to focus on our decision making, the people search this. Now what she says, she says the people search about online, online coaching on this decision making or online coaching on work productivity. So you should note down these things and you can tell me later on WhatsApp and I will guide you the exact method. Although you understand now what. So first you will write down the meta title to me and I will see considering the length of a, because you are not using the tool, I am using the tool, right? So length of the meta title and all, I will edit and send it to you. But do you get the point?
Yes.
You should first ask her, tell me only 2 points. Okay, she tells you 5 points. So just give a priority of it. What are the most important out of these 5? So first we will target those 2, and in this way we can create a next page only on talking about the improved decision making, and this way we will plan the content, and in this way you will enhance your pages, and in this way you will do separate meta title for separate keyword, and in this way you will get the leads.
Okay.
Am I too fast to explain or you understand what I'm saying?
No, I understood. So this is for the meta title. How many words should be there?
So as we discussed, meta title usually takes 55 to 670 characters. So one thing you can calculate on your own, on your Excel, you can put the character. For example, soft. Soft means there are 4 characters, S-O-F-T. So 55 to 70 characters in meta title. Okay. And just give me one minute. I'll help you out in one thing. You go to the Excel, you put this word and you put a formula. You can Google the formula of how to count character in Excel. So when you put that formula, whatever you type, it will give you an indication. So I am mentioning here 55 to 70 characters will be there in meta title. Okay. Now if you calculate this, health is 6, mental is 6, coaching is 8. So 6, 6, 8, how many characters? Only 20. Okay, and this brand mota laga lo 10 to 12, so it is still not reaching to 55. So you can enhance some more keywords over here according to, that's what I'm saying. Ask her the priority understanding, priority keywords, that improved decision making, or work efficiency, and accordingly you can put these keywords over here.
Okay, and okay, fine.
Okay, and this is meta title. And meta description is, again, although meta description is something when people search, it comes on a Google SERP, but you should write meta description as well. That can come to 170 characters, or let us say 160 characters. Okay, where you can mention in detail one-to-one coaching by expert, you can mention her name as well, you can mention the mode, it is online, you can mention the program fee, you can mention some appreciation or something, anything you can mention in description, because description gives you more space to write. Okay. More characters to write. So this is something. So you got my point? In this way, yes, you will do this. Now I'm showing you again my screen just to show you how we do it, although I have shown you again, shown you earlier as well. So let us say I am taking advanced Excel training. Let us say I'm taking this Power BI training, for example, and I click over here. Okay, what is my meta title? You tell me if you can see this.
It's coming. Now it's coming. Yeah, Power BI training archives.
Archives, because there are so many blogs about it, right? Now, if I'm going to this, now tell me the meta title.
Sample Power BI report sample.
And today class, we also discussed the Power BI report simple is coming on a third page, because we are not having any content over there. Still, it is coming on a third page because it is a less competitive keyword. Plus, it is meta title, description, URL, everything is having this keyword. Second thing, it is a long tail, so easy to target. Similarly, you can also create different pages about it, how to improve decision making, how to do work-life balance, whatever your coach teaches or coaches.
Right.
So in this way, you can get in. And on this particular page, which page you just showed me the programs, you can mention your brand and the programs and the just outline of the programs, like one-to-one coaching, then let us say for example mental health, decision making, in this way, just main keyword over there.
And this one-to-one coaching will not be for the home page, no? This will be for the program page.
For the program page. For the home page, just mention the main keyword over there, like, for example, you do coaching about a particular training, so mention that, and then you can mention more. Do not need to mention one-to-one at all. Nobody is going to search the one-to-one at all. People are searching this. But on a program page, why I'm saying one-to-one, when they are searching the main keyword, they're also checking that you are giving a one-to-one coaching over there. And it is up to you whether you want to write one-to-one or not. Now look at this second page over there. I click on HR Analytics report sample, and I went over there. Here I can see HR Analytics report sample. Previous was a Power BI report sample. In this way, I am doing the specific training. Let us say entrepreneurship. So I'm doing the, so here I'm just putting an archive. But if I go to any kind of this blog and all, so I write a specific, specific keyword for this. Like, for example, for this complete page, I'm writing how to plan a career, online career counseling, Edu4Sure. Similarly, you are having a page, this program. So in this way, you can do this.
Okay.
Are you getting my point or not? Because if you make mistake over there, then it would be difficult. For example, this is a training. We do the 30 plus training. So I have not mentioned the training, but I can mention the main training over here, like Power BI, Excel, digital marketing, entrepreneurship, in this way. Okay. But I do not want to mention any training. That's why I didn't do it over here.
Okay.
I'm just checking whether my SEO person has, done this or not for a particular course. Yes. For the particular course, we have done like Power BI course. Okay. Now I'm going to another course. Let us say this DEX course. And this is a DEX course. So we have put a meta title over there as well. Okay.
Yeah.
This is important. So for example, I'm going to intermediate to advanced. So I'm in a meta title, I clearly mention intermediate advanced Excel.
Right.
So in this way, for each page, you are supposed to write a meta title in this way. For example, it is a complete Excel. So I mentioned the complete Excel. But many websites you would find, they will only having a brand name and nothing else, and this is wrong.
Yes, okay.
Okay, so in this way, you are supposed to do.
And so description doesn't come, only meta title comes.
Sorry?
Meta title and description, both of these things come for home page, but for the rest of the pages, only meta title comes.
Sorry, I couldn't get you.
Like when you are hovering on the... Mm-hmm. tab, huh? Then only the meta title is coming, na? Description nahi aa raha hai.
Haan, description will not come. See, description is something. Description is something like best career tips, which is coming on SERP. I told you, na? It comes on SERP. This is description. This. So this will not come on website over there. This is a meta title. This is a page title only.
Okay.
Like certificate courses is a meta title. That is a page title. But description comes over here. When your site will be searched over here, then you will be coming over here.
Okay. So this example, we have to write only once.
For each page, you are supposed to write meta title. For description also, you have to write a different description, na?
For each page.
Yes, description would also be different, na?
Okay.
Because it is up to you what description you want to mention over here.
Okay.
So, like for example, last thing, like for example, I search be a pro blogger. So I find this. This is a description, right?
Yes.
So in this, so same website about pro blogger, he has written this description. Becoming a pro blogger, he has written this different description. So different page, different description kind of thing.
Okay.
Like for example, Edu4Sure has this description. Be a pro blogger, we are coming on a first page, but we have a different description.
Okay.
Are you getting my point?
Yes.
Okay, so just discuss with him, with her, and then WhatsApp me, and then we will do the meta title from there. Okay.
Okay. Sure.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, bye-bye.